The BenQ W1700 is a long-throw home cinema projector capable of displaying true 4K resolution, and it supports HDR, which means you can theoretically get a 110-inch display size at a price that's much lower than that of a premium 65-inch 4K TV. Interested? Well, this is our review. The BenQ W1700 is not too big and should be able to fit within the same amount of space as any other standard home theater projector. It's sized just right to be placed on a shelf and weighs around 4.2 kilograms, which makes it easy to mount. The zoom and focus rings need to be tweaked manually on the projector itself, since that setting is missing from the remote. On the bottom of the device are three adjustable feet, a sliding one for the height adjustment in the front, and two screw-type ones on the rear. Between these three, we found the projector to be quite stable despite the high speed of the fan inside the body. The lens has a helpful cap that, again, needs to be put on or taken off manually. You can see prominent air vents around the body for air intake and exhaust. Next to the right air vent is a grille for the device's mono speaker. Now, all buttons are placed on the top of the unit, and you might not use them very often considering that the remote handles all the same functions as well. The back has all the ports, which include two HDMI ports, both supporting 4K and HDR input. Other ports include a VGA input, an RS-232 control port, and two USB ports, both of which are incapable of playing media from external devices. There are 3.5mm ports for audio input and output, but sadly, no way to route digital audio. The W1700 achieves its 4K resolution using pixel shifting, a technology that uses high-speed flashes of 1080p resolution and micro mirrors to project four times as many pixels on the screen. It's a lower-cost technique, but also without any noticeable drawbacks. The projector supports only HDR10 standard, and there's also active 3D support, but only at a 1080p resolution. The W1700 has a mode in which it can be used for rear projection as well, if that's your preference. Now, BenQ claims that the lamp brightness is 22,000 ANSI lumens, which means that this projector will perform optimally only in pitch black darkness. BenQ also claims that the contrast ratio is about 10,000:1. The remote is quite functional and handles just about all important functions pretty well. The buttons are a bit on the stiffer side and do require some amount of effort to use. To make things a bit more cumbersome, the projector's interface is slightly laggy too. The remote buttons light up in a bright orange when pressed, making it easy for you to see what you're doing in complete darkness. We tested the BenQ W1700 projector primarily by connecting it to a PS4 Pro. BenQ provided us with a 100-inch projection screen for testing, and we were able to fill it up by placing the projector at a distance of around 3.6 meters from the screen. For 4K HDR video, we tested TV shows including Stranger Things, Marvel's The Punisher, Lost in Space, and many more, all of which looked gorgeous. The reds especially were visibly deep in the final conflict of Stranger Things Season 2, and the warm outdoor school sequences had a level of smoothness that you can experience only with high-quality projection. The bright sequences in Lost in Space stood out really well, but not to the point that we had to squint, as we have experienced with QLED TV panels. Still, the mix of size and intensity did look very impressive. Upscaling too was handled pretty well, to the point that we couldn't tell at times whether the media playing on screen was natively 1080p until we checked. We even played a number of YouTube videos and the results were equally good. Projectors, especially DLP ones, are not usually recommended for gaming because of their low refresh rates, but we gave this one a spin anyways. The result was pretty impressive. We did notice a bit of input lag when trying to pull off combos in Injustice 2, but God of War ran perfectly well. We can definitely recommend this non-Twitch based gaming if you're in the mood to play on a larger than life display. What did not impress us at all was the projector's black levels, but again, that isn't something isolated to this particular model. Our testing room also had white walls and ceiling, which would minutely affect the overall black levels in a negative way as well. Watching darker shows and movies does bring this issue to the forefront. So thanks for watching our review, and for all things tech, log on to gadgets360.com.